Chess friends, how are you? Today I will show you the World Chess Championship Game 7 between Ding Liren and Ian Nepo, and this is your today's puzzle, 90 IQ chess puzzle, solve it and comment me. So let's go. Ian started with e4, Ding played French defense. Very few people play this opening in Fide Championship. I think he is over attitude, d4 d5 and we have knight to d2 called Tarish variation. Nepo said to Ding, I will trash you into my smoke bin, c5 by Ding. Now he comes to the point that he really needs a good opening to play, activating your pieces in French setup, knight here and we have center exchange, knight f6, we have another exchanges in the center, knight f3, the knights are jumping like a fork. I wonder what would happen if the founder of chess used a frog piece instead of taking a knight piece. Very laughing ha ha ha, we have knight exchanges and both side decide to do castle, queen e2, his idea is to play like this to activate his bishop like this, bishops are the sniper in chess, c4 is the long term idea, bishop here bishop, d3 and now c4 is coming, Ding says do your best, okay queen e4 to mate you in one move, nope, knight f6, queen to h4 now I am threatening to play bishop f4 to target this what you will play Ding. c5 doesn't protect your queen, so let me move back my queen, now Ding want to take the knight on f3, so knight e5 threatening to play knight here, to fork on your queen and rook, if your knight take the knight on e7, bishop is snipering on there and it will checkmate in one move because the frog will no longer to protect that square, so rook here to protect it, we have rook e1, Nepo's strategy is to move up the rook like this and put pressure to the king position like this, use these file as his needs. If you play any normal move rook here then he will move up his rook, rook here then rook g3 to pressure him, rook here then he will sacrifice his rook by playing rook takes pawn, you have to take it then bishop check, king moves back away then queen here to checkmate you so after rook here knight takes pawn check which is called checkmate, you will lose the world championship, so back to the position we have g6, try to protect the structure like a kangaroo. So the elephant comes to catch fire at your horse's tail with the queen, we have rook here to target it queen backs, queen here b3 and now c3 is coming, Ding doesn't fears it and played like a boss, after the move c3, the rook have no square to run, he played brilliant move knight takes pawn, sacking his own knight because after bishop takes knight he get an another chance to play brilliant move rook takes f4 sacking his another piece, and after rook takes rook we have bishop takes knight. And he have the bishop for the rook, but black have a little advantage of this position, because his bishop army is snipering on the king's position, he have bishop pair and the diagonal is open, so rook here, to target the h-pawn, if you play h4, let me show you. Then white will sacrifice his bishop by playing bishop takes g6, after pawn takes there is queen takes check, king here and rook takes bishop, white will win up material, here if you try to exchange your queens like this, then after rook takes queen, white is totally winning and he win this pawn on his next turn and so on, the rat and cockroach continues his fight by playing rook d8, the cockroach. I mean Ding Liren cannot take this pawn because it is protected by the queen so we have bishop takes bishop, rook takes e4, rook goes to d5 rook to h4 by Ian, queen here and it may looks like it's a free food but you cannot it, if you do then it will return toxic into your king's position, rook to d1, rook takes rook is coming, 200 Elo rated players will think that, let me give you a check then king here then it will be mate on there, a fool is beautiful as long as he says nothing. If the rook give a check then it will be captured by the elephant like Ian Nepo, so, you have to play king f2, rook here to target the queen so the queen moves up then the bishop will come to make you cry and this is coming, your king is exposed while he is in washroom, rook blocks then rook here, threatening queen here to go there to pressure you, queen here bishop check, the king can't go there because of the rook. So rook blocks queen comes queen f3 bishop takes king here rook check backs and takes takes, black is totally winning and chess friends. If you want to be smart in chess then you can like and subscribe to my YouTube channel to get more episodes, back to the position, we have queen e3 by Ian Nepo, h5 g3 bishop backs rook to c4 h4, sacrificing his pawn, Ian accepts it, rook to d2 to target this pawn with the queen, we have rook e2 and rook d3 by Ding, which is a mistake. Best was to play rook d5 because he wins the c5 pawn with queen, rook d1 check, another blunder. Best was to take the queen. He is making mistakes because he had low time. King here, queen to d3, rook here, king to g7. Another mistake move by Ding, and best was to play queen d8 to protect the bishop. So after rook f4, rook batteries are targeting to the bishop and the pawn. Now queen d8 is not available, because if seriously rook takes bishop happen, then queen takes rook and rook takes queen, king takes. It will be a fight between queen and rook where the queen can easily win. It takes almost 30 to 40 best and good moves to win a chess game, and only one blunder move to ruin the game. But Ding Liren plays 4 to 5 blunder moves in a row. Ding Liren loses hope, cries in the bathroom, taking out his pen from his pocket, signing in the resigned documents. He resigned the game, because after queen takes queen, queen takes bishop takes, it is two rooks versus one bishop and one rook, and white is totally winning. So. Wish you all the best, thanks for watching, subscribe for more, bye bye, take care, see you soon.